At this point, you've learned how to blend and shade and make great color choices using the color wheel.
But if you look at that 50 pack, you have a bunch of colors that don't relate to the color wheel. Blacks, browns, even silver and gold. So what do you do with those? I'm here to show you today.
A few quick notes before we get started. I split this video into two, so if you are just interested in learning what to do with those metallic pencils, I'll have a link at the end of this video as well as right here. Second, just a reminder that this video will only be talking about making color choices. I will not be reviewing how to blend or how to shade. If you still need to brush up on those skills, please check out my other videos. I think those will help you out greatly. Last, in this video, I use a 50 pack of Crayola colored pencils, so that's where you'll find these colors. Let's start by talking about black. You're not going to find black on the color wheel, so a really easy way to think about what would blend with black is, what would we get if we added black plus white? The answer is gray. Crayola provides you with three different grays, and the reason there are so many different grays out there is because, yes, black and white would equal gray, but you also get gray if you look at the color wheel. Right smack in the middle of the color wheel, you can find a color they call neutral gray. This is because if you mix all of the colors equally, you do get a neutral gray. So if you add a little bit more of one color like red, it'll be a warmer gray. A little bit more of a cooler color like blue, you'll get a cooler gray. And I'm sure you can imagine that there are seemingly endless amounts of grays that you can create. Crayola gives you three of these grays. Gray, slate, and cool gray. If you look at the paint on the outside of the pencils, it looks like you have three different values of gray, or a dark, medium, and light. What you need to know about these three grays is that they are all the same value. One is not darker than the other, they're just simply three different grays. So you really can't blend one with the other and expect a nice contrast. But what we can do is use black as the darker value and blend it with any of these three grays. I'll show you what this looks like with the first space on the outer ring of the radial design. You can choose whichever gray you prefer. It's honestly just a matter of preference. I personally like slate the best. It's a really blue gray. So I'm gonna use black as the dark value, slate as the medium value, and then I'll shade lighter and lighter into white so it looks like I have a lighter version of slate. Next, let's talk about brown. Crayola gives you a nice range of browns in the 50 pack, and it's honestly really easy to choose a dark, medium, and light just by using their browns. I'm going to start by showing you dark brown, tan, and sand. This is one of my favorite color combinations for a beach or sand. How about colors you can blend with black? Abandoning all color theory and instead going with years of experimenting with these colors, I found that blues and purples blend nicely with black. I recommend to stay on the darker side of blues and purples, so from that 50 pack, I would say that navy blue and violet blend nicely right next to black. For the next color combination, I want to start with black and violet. Black will be my darkest value, violet will be the medium. All I need to do is find a color lighter than violet that will blend nicely. I'm going to choose magenta. So this color combination is black, violet, and magenta. This is a nice way to start a sunset sky that fades into night. Now let's talk about colors that can blend with brown. When looking for colors that can blend with brown, any oranges or golden yellows will work nicely. In fact, you might have noticed that you don't have a color in your 50 pack or 100 pack or Prismacolor pencils that are really a dark orange. Now, I've always used oranges and yellows to blend with brown, but never completely understood why until very recently when I was really studying color theory. That's when I found out that dark orange is actually what we call brown. And I'm just gonna take you into Photoshop for a minute so you can see for yourself. When we open up the color options, this little scroll or bar of color shows you all of the colors, and brown is nowhere to be found. Now check it out, when I click orange, that's where I'm gonna find my browns. For those of you unfamiliar with this screen, when you click anywhere on this square, the rectangle in the top right shows you your new color choice. As you see me click down from bright orange into a dark orange, you're gonna see that color get more and more like what we consider brown. Same with the golden yellow. As I start with a nice bright golden yellow and click down and get darker and darker, it looks more and more like brown. if we go too bright with the yellow, something different happens and it looks kind of like a grayish, yellowish color, which makes sense because I've always noticed that the bright yellows don't blend nicely with the browns. So a golden yellow or orange will blend nicely with brown, and I hope this also explains why some of the browns look a little orangey to you and some of the dark yellows look a little brownish to you. They're in the same color family. For this color combination, I'm going to start monochromatic with a dark and light brown, and then I'm going to work into color by choosing a yellow. So I'm going to choose dark brown, light brown, and harvest gold, which is like a deep golden yellow. We already saw black blended with violet, now let's see it blended with navy blue. For this color combination, I'll use black as the dark value, navy blue for the medium value, and sky blue for the light value. Now I'm going to choose the same first two colors, black and navy blue, but instead of sticking to the blues or monochromatic, I'm going to work up the color wheel. So for this color combination, I'm going to choose black as my dark, navy blue for my medium, and a light purple or orchid for my light value. Now let's stick to the same first two colors, black and navy blue, but instead of working into the purple side of the color wheel, I'm going to move more towards the green side. So for this color combination, I'm trying black, navy blue, and lime green. Once I'd blended the lime green in, I saw that the navy blue and lime green had too much contrast, so I lightened it up with an eraser, looked at the color wheel again, and saw that blue-green was right next to blue. So I'm replacing the lime green with a light blue-green, which is Crayola's Aqua Green. For the next space, I'm going to revisit the black and think about grays. Instead of using the slate, I'm going to try a different gray, and I'm choosing cool gray. In the second part of this video, I'm going to finish off this radial design with the two metallic colors included in the 50-pack, silver and gold. You can watch that right here. If you enjoyed the video and feel like it helped you, please give it that thumbs up. Subscribe to follow my latest videos and lessons. I truly appreciate the support. Until next time, happy creating!